Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I will be watching this. I did say we'll be watching this last episode, so I'm watching
it. Hey, what is going on, guys?
What is the absolute bottom of the GTA 5 ocean? And I'll be quiet and we can watch this.
In GTA 5, and I'm actually really excited to show you guys the result of this, because as the majority of us have probably tried this already, when you do get to the bottom of the ocean, there are actually death barriers set in place, as well as loads of other really frustrating restrictions, which will prevent you guys from basically getting to the bottom of the ocean. So what we have done in today's episode is actually removed those restrictions by using mods. Now, I will leave a link to some of the mods in the description below, so if you guys want to go and check them out and maybe get them for yourself, then of course you guys can. It's super easy to install, but we're going to be using them to make our vehicle and our character both invincible, so we can just keep plowing through the ocean until we get to the absolute bottom of the ocean. So this is super exciting. We're actually going to be confirming one of the most curious questions in today's episode, and this is kind of like a part two to a video I did last week in which we flew to the absolute end of GTA 5, where we basically got into a jet and we flew into the horizon and we removed all of the boundaries and restrictions, and the result is pretty cool. Now, I will leave a link to that video at the end of this episode so you guys can check that out if you want to, but the support you guys left on that video was crazy. We actually smashed 5,000 likes on that episode, so if we could get 5,000 likes again on today's video, then that
we'll
would just
watch
be insane.
Both this one and that one in this
anyway,
episode.
Anyway, just a few seconds before I get into this, I just want to quickly let you guys know I am on Snapchat, and for about a year I have had my Snapchat link in the description of all of my videos, and I haven't actually shouted it out in video, so I thought I may as well just leave it there. I am pretty active on it. You do see me post stories and stuff like that, so if you want to add me on Snapchat, you totally can do. There is a link in the description which will take you to my Snapchat page, so feel free to add me on Snapchat, guys. Anyway, let's get straight into the episode, and to start things off, this is the mod menu I am using, and some of you guys might be complaining I'm using mods. Well, if you don't use mods, guys, you can't actually do this, because without mods, I can't make my character and my vehicle invincible. Now, I just want to quickly throw out there, a small observation I made when I was doing this is that the restrictions are surprisingly higher than I thought. It means you can't really go as deep as you want to without using these mods, which really just surprised me, because I haven't been to the bottom of the ocean for a while. But as I was doing this, when the restriction notes started to kick in, I was thinking, no, this is way too early, but they're actually pretty high up, so I'm pretty surprised Rockstar Games did that. And another observation I made is that there's no boundaries in the ocean. Theoretically, you can just keep going as long as you wanted to. If your body died and you start to sink in the ocean, your body could theoretically keep going down to the bottom of the ocean, along with a shipwreck or any sort of blown up jet or anything like that. It could theoretically go to the absolute bottom, beyond any sort of restriction and boundary. And the reason why I made this kind of observation is because I actually tried to install a no boundaries mod. This is something which I had in my previous video, which basically allowed me to get to the absolute end of GTA 5 without hitting any sort of invisible wall or boundary or anything else like that. But what I realized is that after doing this test in the ocean, there's no invisible barrier. And to give you guys a small example of what an invisible barrier would be, let's say you see a plane crash into the sea, and the plane continues to go deeper and deeper and deeper, and then suddenly it stops. And then let's say, for example, you are able to see this plane wreck in the ocean, but because it's just stopped in midair, it would have most likely stopped on an invisible barrier. This is basically an invisible floor, which I expected Rockstar Games would implement into the ocean. But they haven't, guys. There is no invisible barrier in the ocean, which is crazy. So you can technically just explore as long as you wanted to and go as deep as you wanted to. Anyway, as you can see, I've just got these notes. I've just got these little observation things saying danger. And it looks like my vehicle is just about to die out. But because I do have vehicle invincibility, I thought that, you know what, my Kraken won't blow up. It's got invincibility on. No way will it blow up using this mod. But as I decided to go out further and further and further, something really did surprise me, and this is that my Kraken did actually explode. As you can see right here, it broke, and then just when it hits the ocean floor, it lights up again, which is really, really interesting. I wasn't expecting that. As you can see, it's lit back up, but although the fans are turning, although I can still control it, nothing happens. It won't turn, it won't go up, it won't go down, it won't do anything. So it's kind of like the ocean has got a hold over my Kraken, which is really, really strange. As you can see, I've got invincibility on. I'm trying to see if I can fix the vehicle or anything, but I can't. It's just basically being held by nothing, which is really, really strange. Something I really wasn't expecting, but as you can see, the ocean floor will keep going on. It looks like it's getting deeper and deeper. And as you guys also saw, when my vehicle was destroyed, it still sunk a little bit more. And this was beyond it was destroyed. So this is basically under the restriction. So as you can see, the ocean does level down into what looks like an even deeper ocean. So I decided to try something else out. And this is actually flying out to a really far distance in the ocean, where the ocean bed would basically be as deep as possible if I were to fly directly down to it. And then I'm going to spawn a Kraken, and then I'm going to try and get the absolute bottom of the deepest part of the ocean. So let's give this a try. So when I first tried this out, I came across something extremely interesting. As you can see, I am nowhere near to be seen to the actual map. I believe it's just faded off into the distance, and I decide to jump out of my jet. And then because I'm so far out, it wouldn't actually let me spawn in any other vehicle. So when I did hit into the ocean, I couldn't spawn in my Kraken. Now, this is actually a restricted zone. This is beyond the boundaries in the sky, so if you were to try and get this far out without using mods, it would be impossible. You have to use mods to get this far out. So this is kind of like an invisible part of the ocean, which you can't physically get to, and even if you could, your vehicles wouldn't get there with you because you're not allowed to spawn in vehicles in this kind of section of the ocean. So I decided, you know what, we're going to go a little bit closer to the island. So this is exactly what we do. So now we're a little bit closer. I've just spawned in my Kraken. As you can see, we're quite far out anyway. You can just about see San Andreas as well. So this is extremely far out. And I've spawned in my submarine. Now what I decide to do is try and go down. And this is actually quite a challenge because it keeps going around in spirals as if the Kraken itself is pushing itself back up to the top of the ocean, which is really strange. You don't really see this when you're going around the actual ocean around the map, but when you go so far out, the Kraken will actually try and spiral to the top, so it's automatically lifted to the top of the ocean, which is really interesting. So I actually had to fight to get the Kraken to go deeper and deeper and deeper. It's not difficult to do this, it's just a little bit of a struggle. So this is once again another observation I made. When you do go so far out, the Kraken will automatically lift itself to the top of the ocean, which is extremely interesting to see how Rockstar Games have designed this, as if they don't want you to get to the bottom of the ocean, as if they're hiding something, or as if they just physically don't want you to get there. Anyway, I managed to get through this, and although it's kind of a struggle, it didn't take me long to do anyway. As you can see, I'm already approaching crushing depth, and now as you can see, my engine is closing off. So at this point, we're nowhere near the ocean bed, so I expected myself just to keep kind of falling down. And at first I was thinking, oh yes, this is it, we're gonna fall down to the ocean bed. But then as I started thinking to myself, I started to see things that I didn't even think were happening. For example, as I was looking up, I thought we were getting deeper and deeper as things were getting darker. But then the more I looked at it, nothing was actually happening. Although it looked like my Kraken was sinking, it's not actually doing anything. It's just spiraling around in circles and circles and circles, which is extremely interesting because even if you do get some sort of wreckage, or if you sit in it, or if your plane blows up, and if you just try and sink to the bottom of the ocean, nothing will happen. Your vehicle, your plane, your wreckage, it will just spin around in circles. And the reason why I knew this is because when I put my radar on, I looked at the miles deep kind of counter you can see on the left hand corner, and in the bottom left corner you can see we're 0.15, 0.16 miles deep. It will keep changing from one to the other per spin, and this is simply down to how deep we are. It won't change at all. So this proves to us that we're staying in the exact same place. So right now, I am in the absolute bottom of the ocean, and there is no seabed. So using this logic, there isn't a bottom to the ocean, or at least if there was, I'm at the bottom of the ocean right now. And as you can see, can we see anything? Absolutely not. All I can see is pitch blackness and where the light would enter into the ocean. Underneath me, there's nothing. Around me, there's nothing. And we're at the deepest part anyone can physically get. So what I decided to do is actually get out of the Kraken, and it actually teleported me back to the map, which is insane. So you can't even swim around in this. Even when I'm using mods, even when I've removed all of the boundaries, you physically can't swim. And I tried to do this again. I'm using no clip mode as well. I just go straight to the bottom of the ocean in no clip, just to double check this is a thing. And it really is a thing. Whenever you get beyond the barrier, whenever you get beyond the crushing barrier, the death barrier, it will just teleport you back up. Now, this won't happen in the game. If you are using GTA 5 without mods, then it will kill you before you can hit this teleporting barrier. But if you are using mods and if your character can't die, you will hit the barrier as it's just slightly deeper beyond the death barrier, which the majority of players would hit. So the absolute bottom of the ocean is nothing. There's no bottom of the ocean, and even if you do get that deep, Rockstar Games will just keep you in the same place or teleport your character back to the map. So I hope this video did answer your question, guys, and if it did, please don't leave without smashing that like button, as it would be greatly appreciated, and feel free to subscribe to my channel as well so you won't miss out on any more GTA 5 content every single day. And feel free to check out my other video I did last week, in which we got the horizon of GTA 5 to find out exactly what was at the end of GTA 5. That video is extremely interesting. I think you guys will enjoy it.
Here's the videos right there, guys.
Of course, you can click it on the...
For goodness sake, look around your living rooms, Australia. We're drowning in throw pillows. Pillows that pretend to be pillows. Wake up from the fluff with Australia's favourite, Uncle Toby's Oats.
Who does he even
Hey, what is going on, guys? My name is Nought, and in today's video, I decided just to showcase something which I think you guys are going to find pretty cool. And this is actually getting to the absolute end of GTA 5 if you were to fly all the way out into the ocean. And this is something which very few players have actually been able to do, because in order to do this, you will actually need to use a variety and series of mods. Now, in this video, I will explain exactly how you guys can install those mods and how you can get to the real very end of GTA 5. And I gotta say, it's pretty interesting, and it's something, like I said, which many other players haven't experienced, and it's one of those unanswered questions which I can promise you guys we're gonna answer and show you guys in today's video. And as always, if you do go on to enjoy today's video, please don't leave without smashing that like button. It would be very much appreciated. The support you guys have been giving this channel recently is overwhelming. I cannot describe it. For example, in the video I uploaded yesterday, I explained how the support has been crazy, and I set a like goal of 1,000 likes within the first hour, and you guys smashed that goal by giving that video 1,000 likes in 50 minutes. So thank you so much for the crazy support you guys have been giving this channel recently. Anyway, let's not waste any more time and let's get straight into the video by taking a look at what is at the other side of GTA 5 if you were to fly all the way out into the ocean. So I actually got this idea for the video by Yan2295, a really reputable source in the community. He just got bored one day and he decided to fly to the North Icon. But what he didn't show in that video is everything else which happens when you do get to the North Icon, but a really interesting piece of information he showed me, which pretty much inspired me to do this myself and check out exactly what happens for myself, is this one huge line you can see in the sea. Now, this is actually the boundary line. So when you do reach the limit, you will hit that line and you physically couldn't go any further. But after watching this video, this got me curious. I wanted to know what happened if we were to get past this line, how we were to get past this line, because this is the true map limit, which you're taking a look at right now in that red box. So before you guys try this out for yourself, you're going to have to make sure you have this mod downloaded. A few other guys were also talking about how you can get to the end of the map and showing you guys how to do it, but one huge question was actually regarding the mod, because no one showed the mod, which I found pretty stupid, to be honest, because I know this is something which pretty much every single person on PC wants to do, because it's interesting and it's pretty fun as well. I'll explain exactly what I mean when we do get to the actual limit, but I found it pretty crazy that very few people actually showcased this mod, and it took me a while to even find this mod for myself. So I decided, you know what, guys, here is the mod, download it for yourself so you can try this out for yourself, because that's what everyone wants to do, right? You all want to try this out and you all want to have fun with this. So that is the mod. I will leave a link in the description. All you guys have to do is download it, and it will remove all of the boundaries in GTA 5. And the best way to describe boundaries is not the end of the map. Boundaries are set in place so you don't get to the end of the map, And boundaries, for example, would be sharks attacking you if you do swim too far, which as many of you guys may have experienced, or if you're in a jet, the jet might break down and destroy itself going into the ocean. Basically, the whole point of a boundary is to make it as organic and realistic as possible, that if you were to get close or hit the boundary, your player wouldn't just hit an invisible wall, instead it would kill itself by flying into the ocean if your plane breaks down, or of course getting eaten by sharks. Now, by removing these boundaries, you will not hit into these horrible areas where your plane destroys itself or sharks will swarm you. You can just fly straight through them and you can get to the north icon, which as you can see I am almost at right now. And believe it or not, the actual end of the map is far beyond the north icon. It doesn't take too long to get there. I would say it takes about 5 minutes or so, but the actual boundary of the map is something which I think you guys aren't going to expect at all. And just taking a look behind me, moving side to side, you will notice that the entire of San Andreas is almost hidden away right now. You can just about see it if you look pretty much 180 degrees behind you, but if you were to turn side to side, look at, or take a little glance at this, it's pretty difficult to even make out that that's San Andreas behind you, and in just a few seconds you will notice the entire island will disappear. Now that is exactly how you guys know you have gone so far out into pretty much the unknown of GTA 5. And as you can see, I have just reached the north icon. Take a look at that on my radar. This is the icon everyone can see but can never really get to on their minimap or can never really take a look at. But this is the north icon. I am exactly where the north icon is right now. And believe it or not, the map still goes on. The way to see this north icon is to take a look in my minimap in the bottom left hand side. But this is exactly how far out I am. And it's pretty crazy to even think that you can get this far out in GTA 5. But there is the north icon in the bottom left hand side. We have just flown past it. And we're still going further and further and further away. And what you will notice is in the distance, instead of seeing the normal curve you will see, say for example you're on top of Mount Chiliad or something, you will see kind of like a curved atmosphere around you to try and make it look like you are inside a world or something. You will notice this curve will start to kind of bend itself. And this is exactly how Rockstar Games have shaped the map. So if you can kind of imagine a massive table, and the table is filled with blue, which is the water, and right in the middle is San Andreas, we are getting to the edge of that table, so you can kind of see how Rockstar Games kind of warped and shaped the map to make it look as realistic as possible when you look down into the distance from inside San Andreas, otherwise known as the world of GTA 5. And we're almost at the boundary, guys. Believe it or not, we're 6 minutes in and we're almost at the boundary. And another mod I'm using is called Menu. It is just a simple mod which allows you to apply invincibility onto your aircraft, onto your players, and just allow you to spawn in vehicles as well. It also allows you to use noclip as well in case things get a little bit tricky. So I recommend you guys install that as well. It is called Menu. I will leave a link to that mod in the description, just to allow you to kind of organize and navigate your player in the most simple way when doing this video and when doing this trick and when just exploring to the unknown of GTA 5. And as you can see, just taking a look directly behind me, San Andreas has almost 100% disappeared. Take a look, guys, I'm just flicking behind me right now and it is not there. You can't see this at all. And at this stage, if I took away the minimap, I wouldn't even know which way is forward or backwards now. I just wouldn't know. You are completely in the unknown right now, which is pretty crazy. And I was not expecting to get out this far. And this is 7 minutes in as well, guys. Bear in mind, this is 7 minutes in. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to quickly fast forward the gameplay. I'm just changing the time and everything to see exactly what it would look like and making the weather clear as well, just to allow this video to look a bit better for you guys so you can see a bit more. But I'm just going to fast forward everything a little bit. And to put this into perspective, I think I was flying for about 15 to 20 minutes just trying to get this going. My entire recording itself, the raw footage, was about 25 minutes, touch and go. And that was, of course, with the ending, just messing around at the boundaries and setting things up at the start. So this will take you overall about 15 to 20 minutes to do, but I am going to speed this up because I can tell some of you guys are going to comment below saying speed this up or something. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to speed this up and I'm just going to quickly play it here, because what you will notice is I am shooting missiles, but something really interesting is that you are so far out that the missiles won't even shoot, they just blow up straight behind you. And like I said, I am using a mod, I do have invincibility on, so this won't affect my aircraft carrier at all, but these are missiles, and they're just blowing up straight away, which shows that you can't physically shoot missiles out this far. We are so far into the wilderness, or the unknown of GTA 5, that missiles won't even work. Bullets will, but missiles won't, which is pretty interesting. Anyway, let's speed this up again, and let's get to the actual boundary of GTA 5. So, just speeding it up, as you can see, I think I've sped up about 3 or 4 minutes worth of gameplay. I'm just playing around with the missiles here, but we are so close to the boundaries right now, so close that if you take a look behind you, you will physically see nothing. It would just look like a mirrored reflection, which is super crazy and super interesting. But let's take a look when we hit the boundary. We are just about to hit the boundary. Notice on the water as well, you will notice a few lines from where you actually hit the boundary. But as you can see, the moment you do so, your aircraft carrier will carry on, but your camera won't. And you can control this carrier, you can do whatever you want to it. You can still control your plane. And I actually had to use my minimap to try and navigate this because I almost got lost because it actually went off the camera. But what will happen is your camera will kind of freeze and your aircraft carrier will keep on flying itself. You can do this with any sort of vehicle of your choice, and of course, if you do get it lost, just try and fly it back to the house icon on your radar, and that is how you can get it back. But as you can see, I'm going to try this again, and I believe I did this 2 or 3 times, and I actually crashed it into the water, which was kind of gutting because it took me a while to get out of here. But as you can see, it's pretty simple, pretty easy, and it's pretty cool as well. And I really wasn't expecting this, because what this shows is you can physically go to the infinite end of this map. You can keep going. It won't kill you. It won't stop your character. The only thing which will stop you is your camera will get stuck. And this is exactly what Rockstar Games have set in place. You are at the end of the map, but you can still fly on. You can fly on into the distance, you just won't be able to see exactly what is over the horizon. So right here is the absolute real end of GTA 5. You can't get any further, you can't go any farther on this. You are simply at the real end of the map. And like I said, I was not expecting this. I thought there would just be an invisible wall or something, your aircraft carrier would get stuck or frozen. But something really interesting, something I wasn't expecting, is your aircraft carrier can keep on flying, you can still control it, the only thing which will stop you is the camera being stuck at that one barrier. So there we go guys, that is the real end of GTA 5, and I really do hope you...
And I also hope, really hope that you liked this video. If you did, subscribe, hit the like button as well, get this video up to 12 likes, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.